Hi, everybody! Welcome back! Happy Friday! It's Kerbal Day. Kerbal Day. We got Kerbal Day. We got Kerbal Day. Kerbal Day, Kerbal Day, Kerbal Day. Kerbal Day, Kerbal Day, Kerbal Day. Fill it up! So, when we last left our heroes, we had expanded our tech tree. We had got some general rocketresses and some status abilities. We need to get some additional aviation stuff so we can build a little rover dude. That's 45 science. So I think we're going to focus a little bit on science, but we also still need to knock out some contracts. I think we had one pending contract. Escape the atmosphere. Test the heat shield. So we can kind of do these guys and maybe this one all in conjunction with one another. So... let's see what we can build that will get us into... That's just escape the atmosphere. That's not an orbit, right? Yeah, escape the cat. Okay. So we're going to build this. Heat shield, because we need to test a heat shield. Right? Yes, test heat shield. That doesn't have a speed. Oh, it does have a speed associated with it. No. Thermal. We need thermal resistance. Which means we need to have a parachutes. A pair of chutes. And I think we could test. It can't be staged though. Or can it? No, I don't think it can, but we'll see. Gotta think this through here. Put that there. We'll put this here. And we'll kick this over here. That should work. I think. We're gonna know real quick. Okay. We still need this guy. Right there. And we're gonna need this fat little feller here. We're at 4.69 tons. And I think if we go... Where's our hammer? There's our hammer. Aye, that'll give us thrust. I think we have some aerodynamics on that too, don't we? We do. We now have nose cones. What do we have? Oh no! We've exceeded the weight of the pad. Okay, so let's go two of these. There we go. And didn't matter which engine. Okay. I think we got it. I think we got it. Let's see. Probably even go a little bit further and put these guys on here. Just for the sake of conversation, we're going to move you up here. We're going to move you guys up here. All right. And do we have auto strutting? We have rigid attachment, but I don't think we have auto strut. We should put some fins on this for a little bit of stability. Okay. Think we're at 13.2 tons. What's our thrust to weight? 1.58. Perfect. That's what we want. Okay. We'll see how well this this goes here, but hopefully we can achieve some kind of orbit here. We want to pull up all these. We can collapse. To perform this test, use the run test option in the parts context menu. And all test conditions are met. Okay, these are the ones we need to be concerned about here. Hopefully we have enough fuel. We may not have enough fuel to reach the height we need. I think we ran into this problem last time. And not gonna be good. We exceeded our speed just a wee bit. Yeah, we're a little high here. But I think we escaped the atmosphere. Let's take a crew report while we're up here. Am I all out of power? No, we got plenty of power. Hopefully. Okay, those are clearly out. Heat shield. Hopefully we can test the heat shield. And we can test the decoupler here, because we still had the T2 or the T12 decoupler. I'm sorry, it went out. It says is now live stream Kerbal Space Program continue our adventure. So it went out. You may have those notifications turned off. Re-entering the atmosphere. What are you barking at, Polly? Just gotta wait for all these to go green. Well, we didn't meet the altitude requirement. It came down really fast. But we can test the decoupler. Test it! Is our parachute gonna get... Yay! We did the parachute test now, too! We got the parachute, we got the coupler, we got the escape. So now we just needed the heat shield and the hammer that we didn't get tested. Thank you. We do a crew report. No, here. Let's do an EVA. Take data. Store data. EVA. Board. Crew report. Yes. EVA. Take data, store data, board. Can't even tell that we're falling here. There it goes, finally. Nice. Well, you know, it's like I say to people, technology's definitely been put here to make us miserable. That's just the way things are, you know? Let's see here. We've got a parachute, don't we? Let go. Woohoo! Now we can just gingerly float our way down. Stalled out. I think that's already fallen to its death. I'm not directly underneath it. And we're coming in. We gotta do the zigzag. Where's my castle? Uh-oh. Where's my castle? I can't see my castle. This isn't good. There it is. We're not too far away from it. Actually, pretty close. Oh, I'm actually really close to it. I wonder if that's what that big circle is right there. Is the shadow of the capsule gonna fall right on my noggin? Nah, it'll be. It's a ways away from me. Just don't know why I can't see it. Gotta be there. Up oh, there she is. There it is, right there. He's coming down, man. I've never had a capsule fall on me. Oh, this one might end up. Nah, it's gonna land over here. See how close we got. Had to walk forward a little bit. Let's see here. Yeah, I think it's gonna drop right about here. That was awesome. Okay, we're gonna plant a flag here. Plant flag. Doop. We left the planet. We went higher and faster than any other Kerbal in history. Repack chute. Board. Recover. What, having a capsule fall on you? All right, we got some fairly good science. We got 30 science on that round, so that'll allow us to get an aircraft. And we got some really good parts refunded here. And we got a lot of money on that because we completed some good contracts. Okay. Let's come in here. Let's buy us some aviation parts and let's go collect a bunch of science. Because we need science. We're gonna start with you. And then we're gonna start with some fuselage shows. Oh, I don't have any. Oh wait, no, I want structure. Where's my I thought I had. That's what I'm looking for. Doink. And we want some air intakes on those. And tell me we've got, we do, we got a nice little engine right there. But I think we need I don't have anything smaller. Can I tweak scale that? Nope. That's okay. It'll look silly, but I think we'll be okay. Now we need our gear of the landing. And now we load it up with science. Where's all of our delicious science? We're going to put you here. We're going to put you here. We're going to put you here. And we're going to put you. We'll put you here. Put two of you there. Nice. The little flame, little satellite pup. Yeah, I've done that too. Those are good times. Those are good times. Yeah, we probably ought to put some navigation lights on this. Just for the smiles and giggles. I'll put these right here. And we'll put these right here. And we need to have Bob. Let's go collect science. Log temperature. I've done that already. Observe goo. We'll collect you. Break. Log pressure data. We've done that already. Have we already done a crew report here too? We have. Okay. So we want to EVA. Collect data. Don't show again. Remove. Restore experiment. Restore. Now, if I let go, this is going to be the problem, right? Okay, good. I can. Okay. Let's go ahead and turn these engines on. Now we start our little adventure, running on down the runway. It's a bumpy runway, too. is going on to nighttime, aren't we? So we may have to run with the lights on. It's actually smoother on the grass than it is on the dirt. Yeah, it's a decent, this is usually one of the little crafts I do to get science going, you know. It's a good roller. Alright. Let's, see what happens if we do a crew report from here. Crew report from Space Plane Hangar. Alright, awesome. And we want to log the temperature. And we want to more mystery goo. Okay, now we're gonna EVA. And we're gonna get some EVA data. And we're gonna take our data. And we're gonna store our data. Take. Collect. I'm gonna have to get down for that one. Store experiments. Probably could have put this a little closer. Grab, climb on up, board, kick our brakes off. EVA. This should be from the plane hangar like we did before. Yep. Take data, collect data, restore. We're gonna have to drop down, release the brake, and see if we can push this thing back. Store experiments, take data, store experiments again, board, oh, I don't have the brake engaged, okay. I'm gonna have to let go and see if we can push this thing back here. I guess I can't push on that wheel.
can stop it. Turn around so we can stop it. It rolls really well. It rolls better than I thought it would. Come on. Hurry. Grab on. Climb up.
Bored. All right. Hit our brakes here. Gotta charge my power up here. Doing the charging, getting some power. Does this have... I thought there was a way to change the screen. What'd I do? I moved to the rear seat. Is this a two-person? Oh no, this is the docking. Okay. Release the brakes. Crew report from the astronaut complex. And we EVA. Wash, rinse, repeat. That's all we're doing here. Grab you, take the data, collect the data, restore. We're gonna take data and experiments. We're gonna store data and experiments. We're gonna let go. Walk back to here. And take this data. You didn't think to use the outboard engines for pushing the craft, or? Our brakes in place. We're going to throttle this thing up just a little bit. And do our crew report. do our EVA. Collect. Collect. Restore. Take and store experiments. I'm going to have to get out and push this thing back again, aren't I? Oh no, it's slowly rolling backwards. Let's let it slowly roll backwards here. Oh, yeah. Yeah, no, this is one of the ways I set up my a lot of my science vessels for doing this kind of stuff. I'm going to have to get out and push it again, aren't I? Run this way. Run fast, fast, run. Don't let go. Wait. All right. Return. Oh, that used a lot of power. Report. EVA, EVA. Take and store. Data, collect data, store experiments, restore, wash, rinse, repeat. Okay, we want to turn this. Kick the brake off, see if we can turn this so it noses in. Doom. Report. because we've got to be resting against it to get these readings. Data, collect data, restore, store these experiments, which I can't because I think I've already done them. Yes, which is weird because I thought those were, let's review data, let's transmit that. Uh-oh, ran out of power. Can we make it through? Oh no! Oh good, we can clip through that. What is that? That's some weird little flagpole, I guess. Alright, over here to research and development. Cancel. EVA. Take data. Store data. EVA. Grab. Board. Yeah. All right. Let's head over here to our tracking station. EVA. Take all the experiments, store all the experiments, take data, collect data, store experiments. Store, log, oh, take data, didn't get the space plane or the vehicle assembly building, did we? This thing doesn't turn very sharp. Report. EVA. EVA. Take. Store. Take. Collect. Restore. Store data. Let us go. Take data. Board it. No, no, it doesn't have the stairway walking up, so no, you cannot. Which is sad, because I was really looking forward to going up there. Alright, we need to come over here to the administration building. We haven't got anything from there yet. Report. Log. Observe. Log. EVA. Take your data. Collect your data, restore, drop on down. We drop on down, we turn it around. Take data. Grab. And we take the data, we store the data, we board. Okay, let's go get some water readings. Trying to control my speed here a bit, so I'm slowing myself down so I don't hit the ocean at, you know, 45 meters a second. Spending a lot of time just getting ourselves online. I'll go play in the ocean for a minute. I don't know if this is from the shores here or not. I think it might be from the shores, but I want to double check. We haven't collected anything from the shore yet. Yeah, you always complain there's no spacesuit necessary. And take and store. Restore. Take data. This thing's bouncy. Alright, so we got it from the shore. That's awesome. I'm on the wrong side of the planet. Is this still shore or is this considered beach? This is still shore, okay. I am full brake and I am picking up speed here. I wonder why I'm tilted like this. I am technically moving here, and can I EVA here? I can. Question is, am I going to be able to collect all my stuff here without losing my vessel? My nuclear vessel. Yes, board anyway. I don't know which one it was, but Yes, I mean, I'm in the ocean. No, but see, I've got experiments on this side, too. Yeah, it's just Kerbal physics. We'll balance it out with the rotation. I really don't know where I'm going. We collected all the science we wanted to collect right now, so. Guess it's time to head back to the beaches. Now, if I put a little bit of fins on this thing, it'll probably sit better in the water instead of being unstable, but. Yes, exactly. It's just a simple fact, this thing was never designed to go in the water. And Pickle Rick, first time chat. Thanks for joining. Glad you could be here. We're just doing a career mode. Collecting as much science as we can right now so we can get bigger, better stuff. I should probably cut my engine here so we don't hit the beach at 900 miles an hour. Probably gonna rip the front landing gear off. Now we're gonna fall back into the water. Am I gonna have the oomph to get this thing up off the beach? Yeah. Play as you watch. That's the fun part about it, right? Some of my best play times are while I'm watching. Alright, I'll get this thing. Isn't the obelisk over here? Yeah, it's over there. Let's go see the obelisk. I don't think there's a lot of science you can collect around the obelisk, is there? I don't remember. Don't think it's something you can clip on. I think you can go right through it. I don't think it's a solid object. It's been a while since I've been over here. Probably ought to start applying a little bit of brake here in case it is a solid object. Solid. just the shores. Okay. Yeah. I'm sure there's some kind of scientific experiment you can run on it. I think there's like a sound experiment or something you can run. Alright, let's go ahead and stop this thing and reclaim it. I think we got the science we needed anyway. Science. Nice. Okay. And we got our refund for all those parts. No XP gain because he didn't really do anything awesome. Alright. Do we need command and control? Might want to. I don't know. We'll think about it. General construction. That's what I was looking for the plane. Is that guy right there, the structural fuselage. But having basic science would be good, too. See, we've got 140. Let's get the bigger tanks and rocket and motors here. Oh, look, fireworks. We'll get those. Then I think we'll get the science. Because that'll give us a battery, which is good. And I think it gives us a... Yeah, it gives us a little space probe to play with. So we'll go with those. Okay. Leaves us with 50, so we can get one more thing, which I think we might want either the general construction... What do you think? General construction or flight controls? If we do the flight controls, we can actually go do some of those survey missions in a plane. Question is, do I want to spend an hour or so flying around to all those places? Maybe not tonight. Maybe we'll do it another night. So we're going to hold off on the flight controls. Let's go ahead and get the general construction. Because as we start getting these things bigger, we're going to need a way to hold them up. So we'll go with that. All right. And do we have the money to upgrade the launch pad? That is not the droid I was looking for. There we go. 50K. That will allow a lot more weight. That'll allow up to 140 tons. Yeah, let's upgrade that. And right now, I don't think we can upgrade anything else, can we? I don't think we want to spend the $282,000 on that. If we upgrade our tracking station, orbits visible on map. Max power is 2G. Yeah, we don't have too much of an issue communicating right now. I think we're going to hold on to our cash for a bit. Yeah, think we're going to hold on to our cash for just a minute. Let's come into the administration building. Let's do some fundraising. I don't think we can commit because we don't have the cash. Oh, we don't have the setup costs. Okay. Got to remember how these work. Aggressive, noctase. A more assertive stance on the negotiation. I probably won't see it this way. Definitely have it our way. Negative 1.3 on reputation costs. We're going to hold off on this for a minute. I got to look into some of those. All right. What contacts do we have? I don't think we have enough to orbit Kerbin yet. Well, no, we just upgraded our launch pad, so yes, we could build a larger rocket for orbiting. Ferry 3 tourists safely to their destination and back. Suborbital spaceflight. Suborbital. I don't think we have... Well, I guess technically we could stack them all together, couldn't we? All right, we're going to select this one. I think we can do it. And I think maybe we could even do this. I have a plan for how we're going to shuttle these guys. Decrippling. We're going to put parachutes on him. Because, you know, we got to bring him home safely one way or another. Yeah, don't ask me what I'm building, because, honestly... I have no idea. I just know we're building something wicked cool. All right, what's our weight? 3.78 tons. Okay. Someone's gotta have the heat shield. Actually, I should probably... put all these down here. Because you know it's gonna happen. I'm gonna end up killing some of them because... I didn't have it staged right. What am I building? Okay. We need one more decoupler. I'm building something crazy. We're going to have you guys open at 2100 full spread angle. 2100 full spread angle. 2100 full spread angle. 2100 full spread angle. Okay. Everyone should come home safe. We got some big old fuel tanks now, don't we? Aye, that'll give us push. That's going to give us enough fuel. I think we need one more tank. We're going suborbital here. Auto strut in the cities. Gotta keep this thing together. Alright. What's our weight? 12 tons. What's our thrust to weight ratio? 1.37. I think we're gonna need some help, Dave. Alright, that should give us more than enough thrust. I think we got a little bit of overkill here. We also need a couple of these so we can test. A couple of these. We really only need test one, but a little bit of boost is better than no boost. And these guys, we can literally just take, drop down to where they're just a spit of fuel in each one of them. Okay. Yeah, it is a realistic thrust to weight ratio. We want these guys up here. Okay. And we want to go auto-strut. Auto-strut. See if we can complete that one too. What do you think? Think this will achieve suborbital? I'm thinking it will. Now, where are our crew? Tourist? Tourist? Tourist. Alright, Jeb. You're up, man. He's in Bermuda shorts. That's awesome. All right. Prepare for a spectacular failure.
Craft has too many parts. Oh no! I didn't even pay attention to my part count. How many parts do I have? 32. Well, I guess we could do away with some aerodynamics. And engage. Get to that. I think we'll exceed that speed a little bit by the time we're up at that. Oops. Slow this thing down just a smidgen. Trying to dial this thing back, so I'm right in this area here to test these hammers. Getting almost up to our height here. Okay, are we going to be able to coast down to the speed in time? Come on, go green, go green, go green. Okay, got that one. We got the hammers. Alright, let's get these guys suborbital here, huh? Yes! Barely made it! Kick that dead weight off. Come on, almost there. Almost there, almost at the 70K. Nice. We achieved the suborbital flight. Gotta love it.
Wasn't a very long flight, but it was long enough. Now, hopefully, we can get to the speed of the heat shield here. At the altitude we need. Because that would be awesome if we could complete the test of the heat shield. We need it to be 1520 to 1880. Yeah, the stage tumbling is good too. You know, really, even that suborbital flight that these guys experience, that would still be an awe-inspiring event to be part of. It really, really would. I don't think I'm going to get the speed because I am falling through the altitude really, really fast. Yeah, I've lost the altitude and I didn't have the speed. Okay, well, that's a... Yeah, well, you know, he's... What do you expect from a recovering alcoholic who wasted a lot of his life belittling his co-stars, thinking he was the end-all and be-all of... Uh-oh. Coming down pretty fast. This is why I set the altitude so high on these things. Oh, really? Is everybody else okay? One, two, three, four. Well, that seems like all four of them. Nobody's died. These people are just tumbling because they're tourists. They look a little worried. Uh-oh. There we go. I think our head tourist here is gonna hit the ground first. Where's all of our others? Wow, she really. I think this one was set for a lower altitude though, wasn't it? No, 2100. She's falling slightly faster. She's at 5. I think the others are. Yeah, she's falling faster. That's why. Right. Yeah, I'm sure they're all pretty pretty freaked out right now. I wish I could get it to stop spinning, but I can't get it to stop spinning. The others have stopped spinning. That one is just spinning around. I hope that's not gonna hurt it when it impacts the water. She's just about down. Alright, so we checked the hammers off. We got the suborbital flight. What else did we get? We didn't achieve this one, but up and out of the atmosphere and accelerate in a stable orbit. Do I have to bring it back? Because I could do that with a probe right now. I don't think it has to be a manned flight. I probably could have just gone with the three of these things and had a probe help her down. I hope they don't land on each other. That's one down. Yeah, he's gonna risk it. That's what Jebediah does. Just spinning out of control. Oh, it's gonna get tangled up in the other vessel. It can't do nothing. Can I even EVA? Oh, he can EVA. That may not be a good idea, though. Got a parachute though, right? Tourist may not disembark from the vessel. Okay. Yeah. Here, let's do this. Maybe this'll. No, that only made it worse. Jebediah's coming down. Good job, Jim. See, he's an expert pilot. That's what he can do. I should have put these rings on different. Put these rings on the bottom so that when they separated, they stayed with the bottom of the capsule instead of on the top of the capsule. Hey, at least you got to have bacon and eggs, right? Speed this up. Really get them spinning. Gonna hit the water at the same time. Poor Joe. Oh, he seems to be enjoying himself though. I mean, he's not freaked out. He's Oh, that would. Oh, jeez. Yeah, that's. All right. Are they all in a nicely packed area? One, two. Oh, yeah, the other one's about 169 meters away. She drifted a bit. Okay. Can we recover all craft? I guess not. I have to go in the tracking center and grab them all. Yay! Tourists. Oh, untitled spacecraft. Why is it showing that's like a fuselage debris piece? Jebediah. All right, we're gonna have to exit and come back in to get that other one. Did I get all three? I mean, I must have, right? Let's see. Yeah, I mean, it says I completed it, so we got some fairly decent reputation off that one. Let's see here. Yeah. I guess they all came back. Yeah. Yeah, you gotta watch whether it's piloted or not. That's what I was looking at with that suborbital. I'm going, do I actually have to have a pilot on that? Or can I just send a probe up, right? It just says fly a vessel out of the atmosphere. So. Well, that's always good. So, since we've had such good luck with this, we're gonna set you aside. We're gonna toss all you guys into there, and we're gonna go with this guy. I think we need to put a battery on this though. Because I don't think this thing needs to return. It just needs to get orbital, right? To achieve goal, accelerate parallel with the surface until you are in a stable orbit to achieve this goal. Yeah, I don't even think this thing needs to return. I think it just gotta. It's gotta fly to the moon! That's huge. This probably needs some form of communication, but we need to put some batteries on it too. Have anything smaller than a terrier, do we? That's gonna be a quick little oomph. No, it doesn't, but I just need to get it up into orbit, right? And I think that lifter body is more than enough to do that. In fact, now that we've gained some parts back, we can actually go here. It gives us that little extra oomph. Let's put some aerodynamical. I don't even have any solar panel cells yet, do I? No, I don't. Just batteries. That's okay. Staging good. Yes. Okay. It's immediately listing. Yeah, this thing has like no flight control whatsoever. All right, I know how to fix this problem. Revert to vehicle assembly plant. Big control surfaces. Big shiny control surfaces. Because as long as it's big and shiny, it's going to work. Okay. Now it'll stay straight. Yeah, whatever. Come on, you will fly. It's all gone wrong. No. goner. All right, let's revert play. Things were going okay. Let's just naturally let this thing do a normal gravity turn and see how it goes. Yeah, that's... I don't know. We'll have to see. This might turn into a nice gravity turn here. Nah, it's still tearing it apart. Revert flight. I think I need to take this and rotate it this way. Yeah, no, I that's about when I started playing too. I remember when there wasn't even, you would see the heat on the reentry, but you wouldn't actually, you could come in the atmosphere like 4,000 kilometers a minute and not burn up, right? Oh yeah, no, I think I spent around there like $9-$10, so. Yeah, good times, man. Yeah, I've been playing it since 2015. Well, yeah, KSP2 picked up all the inherent features of the original KSP when it was in early alpha. So, whoa, too much. It's all gone wrong. Come on, stabilize. Float away. Go. Yay! It didn't blow apart this time. Yeah, I think I have a total of like 7 hours in KSP2, but a lot of that was watching all the training videos. See, we're gonna rotate this thing over just a bit. That's actually a fairly nice gravity turn, to be honest. I don't think I'm going to achieve orbit with this. Nope. Got a lot of height. I guess if I had flattened this thing out a little more, could have done it, but let's revert flight. Vehicle assembly. I thought little Sputnik was going to be the thing to do it with, but it's definitely not. Oh, hello. That would be why I couldn't attach anything to that. Let's put a parachute on this thing. And I probably ought to put, just for smiles and giggles, a heat shield and a decrappler. Who should we take? All right, Jebediah it is. Yeah, a lot of those early mods were kind of sparse with some of those because they didn't have a lot of the key features that they have now. Oh, I so miss ScanSat, man. I loved ScanSat. You had some of the best science with ScanSat. I just... I think I need more fuel. It doesn't work on the newer version ever since they added, like, their front-end loader. I think it was kind of diminished before that. I think the guy who was developing it kind of gave up on it. Still didn't get it. Even trying to flatten this. I need more fuel. I think I need one more tank. question is this thing going to kick off the way it should? Maybe I should bring these guys down to here. Does I have a swivel on there? Yeah, swivel's what I have. Hey, I'm already past 2 hours. What's wrong with me? Just trying to get this thing in orbit. That's what's wrong with me. Trying to think too much, get it in orbit. Sun. Yeah. Oh. Going the wrong way. It's all reversed. It's all going wrong. I just totally botched this. All right, revert flight. I've got to figure out why this thing is pitching over the way it is. Where is our center of gravity and where is our aerodynamic? I mean, that's all in alignment. Why is it pitching over? Where's our thrust? It's symmetrical. It can't possibly be the, do I have somebody crooked? Is that what it is? No, they're all straight. All right. It's got to be those batteries. Eer. Okay, I fixed that for them. Let's see how it flies now. Center of lift is above the center of gravity. Was it? It is my center of mass. Oh, center of lift. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Okay. I'm with you. I just do away with those fins. Oh no! Now it's way up there at the top. You're saying center of G. I think you mean center of mass. That gets us a little closer. Oh, because that's, we don't want to do it that way. We want to do it. What's the key? Why are you not? Yeah, that's what I want right there. You know, I could just move these guys here down too. That'll change a lot of it. Yay! Now it looks ridiculous. Looks pretty cool. I like it. More fins. All right, this is gonna. Oh, we exceeded the parts. Of course we did. And this isn't my sandbox. What am I thinking? That's why I didn't want to do that. 38 parts. Okay, we're gonna have to take those out. We're gonna have to take these off. We're gonna have to take these off. And we're gonna have to take these off. There we go. Now we're still ahead of the game like we were before. And what if we take these bad boys? Because then when they separate, they'll just smash right into us and destroy the whole rocket. Yay! Yeah. Earth thrust is right there now. Hey, I mean, it's gonna fly one way or another. It's really not. I gotta fix that staging. That would have been bad. I should have these guys kick off with this. Give me that little something extra. that's what I did. My center of lift is behind my center of gravity. But now when they separate, they're going to come out and then come back in and crush my ship. But we'll see what happens. What could possibly go wrong? I still don't think I'm going to have enough fuel to do this. But we'll see what happens. They collided with themselves. Just like they're supposed to. Yeah, we may actually do it this time. Start getting some horizontal action out of this thing here. As we're definitely come on, give us horizontal thrust. I don't think I can make a maneuver node, can I? Nope, we're gonna have to just guess. Heating up the size of the tank full of hydrogen. Yeah, you know, I mean, we've already seen how that happens once in history, haven't we? Yeah, that did not go over well in the 80s, did it? I was watching live that day, too. Begged my teacher to watch it. Begged her. Told her it's history. Changing event. We'll never see anything like it again in our lifetime. If only I knew then what I know now. Nice. Yeah, I wasn't wrong. My teacher was, yeah, she shut it off real quick. I was kind of mad. I'm like, but explosion! And she said, but people died. And I said, but explosion! Done. Shut off. Shut off. I need that fuel to get back. You brought me up too high. I achieved orbit. I guess in reality, I can just flip this thing around now and bring it home, huh? I don't have to go a whole orbit. Bye-bye. Oh, I forgot I still had this guy. Nice. I mean, I guess that's one way to do it, right? Well, we're flying at the right speed. We just need to get the altitude now. Oh, come on. What's wrong with dead trainees, right? I mean, come on. How much paperwork could that possibly be? I still got a lot of fuel left in that. I mean, technically, it just says run experiment, right? Run test option in the parts context menu when all the test parameters are met. Now we're going too fast. We're basically going to use this to control the speed of the vessel as we're making our descent. Why is my speed not right now? Oh. How do I run the test? Where's my perform test? And I'm out of it. Dang it. You know, I seem to think I had a problem with this contract before, too. I think I needed a second heat shield or something. Alright, well, we achieved the orbital goal, so that's something. I think we're gonna call it there, guys. We're gonna land this thing, I'm gonna call it a night, and... yeah! Bring this thing in here. Yeah, you mentioned that just as you order, but see, that's how it always works. As soon as you order the replacement part, that's when everything decides, you know what? We're gonna start behaving now. I had that happen to me once. I had a system where I was positive the motherboard was bad on it. Positive. System wouldn't start up. Nothing. You hit the power button. Nothing happens. Hit the power button. Nothing happens. Unplugged it. Press and held the power button. All that kind of neat stuff. Nothing. And as soon as the new motherboard came, I'm like, you know what? Let's just try this one more time. Hit the button. Thing fired right up. Ran perfectly from there on out. I had a motherboard sitting there for like months. I eventually built another system. It turned into my wife's system after that. Yeah. Yay! Coming in to splash down. Yes, don't. I thought I clicked don't show this again. Well, we got that contract cleared. Look at all the parts we got back. Advance to level 1. Yay! Good job, Jed! Get a couple of scientists. Their stupidity is really high! I really like the music in here. It's pretty cool. Alrighty, guys. I'm going to go ahead and call it there. Thanks for joining. Glad you had fun. If you had fun, encourage your friends to watch. If you miss any of my streams, it's over on YouTube. Hit like, subscribe. All the neat things that you need to do to notify you that I am streaming. And I will catch everybody else later.